Hi, this is Jonah Zimeles, and welcome to Books in Action. Today we decided to do something a little bit different from the long and illustrious history of Books in Action, and we're bringing you today books as art objects. And we're very pleased to have with us today the two folks who've come up with this project, Claudia Soar and Deborah Kaplan. Welcome to our show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's start with you guys. Maybe just tell us a little bit about yourselves, and then we'll find out about your project.
Okay, I'm Deborah Kaplan. I work with Penguin Group for Young Readers, and usually I'm working with books as a reading object, not as an art object. So this was a unique project that was really exciting to work with.
And I am Claudia Soar, and I teach at the middle school in Millburn. And the book project, the art object, just came into being where we were thinking about using books as sculptures and playing with paper and folds and curling and cutting. And it just came to be. And so it's been an exciting piece of art to work with. And the wonderful thing about it, too, is that every child can really do this, and that's the beauty of the project. These are done by eighth graders. There's a nice selection here, where this piece right here is the same fold throughout the entire book. So it really just takes time and some patience, and it allows you just to slow down for a minute. So this is just a series of triangles folded into each page and just repeated, so you have this very clean, classic look. And then eighth graders are doing their thing, which they do so well. They go beyond my expectations and then work with folded patterns where they can piece sort of chunks of different works here and then do some collaging and painting and cutting. And so it can be simple or it can get a little more complicated.
And so each one of these is an individual work of art,
isn't it? Each one is an individual work of art, yes.
Yes. Also, the beauty of this project is it's repurposing and recycling books. These are books that were, what did you call them?
I called them rescue books. Most of these have been saved from garbage heaps and basements and garages. So the students are working with some older books and some books that have been read and are ready to move on.
And repurposing.
Yes, so exactly.
That's terrific.
Exactly.
And Deborah, how did you get involved in this project?
Well, I live in Maplewood. I've been here for about 20 years, and of course I love books, and I love our local bookstore, Words. And when I walk by the windows at Words, I always was thinking, what can we put in the window to make it like exciting and have conversation and interest and draw people into the store? So I spoke with Claudia, and we came up with an idea for this project, and it was a perfect project to do with the community and with teens in the community.
And so you had this up in the bookstore, and were there kids who helped you do the original art installation
and
the
project?
We did
one or two, but basically we were out front and decorating and shifting and dressing the window.
Right. But all of these books were created by the...
These are all students.
That's what
student
I'm saying,
work.
I'm sorry.
All,
so all, the, all the books were, were created by students. Fantastic. In your,
in
originally
school.
In your
sure.
school.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, in the middle school. So I have books in my living room that are folded. I have them at school. I have them in my classroom. And I think Deborah and I both share a love of books and paper and words and stories. And so this is just sort of a really beautiful result that has taken our beautiful books that now are sort of a piece of honor that we can use for further looking in our digital world. You know, we're shifting and changing.
Right.
So it's nice to have these pieces around.
And how did your students react when you told them about the project?
They were very curious, and they weren't sure about folding pages in a book because we've always been told not to damage the book. So I showed a few samples of mine, and I showed them some YouTube works I had got online after I was inspired by my daughter, who had folded down her planner from high school every day when she was finished with the project or the test. She would fold the corners, and I thought it was really interesting, so I went online, looked it up, and lo and behold, it was all over the internet, different folded books. But I researched it. I fold some books myself, and I brought it in, and the children loved it. And they thought it was cool and unique and different.
And how long did it take each of them to, I mean, on average, to do one of these?
They take, I would say, an hour and a half or so to
do. It depends
do.
On how complex.
It depends, yeah.
Of course, yep.
And then they went home, and they were folding at home and on vacation and bringing things in. And when you can excite students to work other than in the classroom, to take things outside the school and to be inspired like that, that's exciting. So it
Terrific.
Was it's fun. And it's and it has grown from that into more of an interesting, you know, collection than I really thought it had been. So the students have inspired me. They really have, so.
That's great. And so I know in addition to, you started out doing the installation did in the bookstore window, and then you moved to the Maplewood Library,
is that
Library,
right? Yep.
And tell us what you did there, or what they...
We just put them in the library. They had some viewing space there, and I think it just reached a different audience than was walking
sure.
by then. Yeah, so a lot of other people saw it, and of course their first reaction was, oh my God, how can you do this to a book? And then, of course, it was explained that it was repurposing the book and bringing it into a different life, and then people were very intrigued by it.
That's terrific.
But I think also the marriage of showing books in a bookstore and books in a library, and then taking it to another level of, after we've read these books, look what else you can do with this, you know, beautiful object. And it stirred a lot of conversation and buzz and excitement.
Yes, I know at the bookstore we had tons of people coming by and saying how excited they were about the window and what a beautiful project it was.
Yeah.
Something that everybody in town was talking about. It became kind of the talk of the town.
That was great.
It looks nice at night. Your window with all the books with your lights on looks quite beautiful with the folded books. So Deborah and I have had a lot of fun together. We're back and making art together. We've known each other for about 30 years. And
wow.
I think our friendship started in Hoboken, right?
Yep. And we both lived in Maplewood for the past 20 years. And it's great to have a bookstore in town.
Oh, thank you.
Yes,
honored.
We love it.
We really love it.
We're both members and we both shop there often.
Thank you.
So it's great. It's really great.
Wow. So, but on this particular project, you just decided to, you know, how exactly did the collaboration come about?
I think, Deborah, you
I had been, I had
talking
been
about the window,
thinking
talking
about
the window
and what to do in the window and what could be a creative, fun project that would tie into books. And I thought, well, Claudia, who teaches art, we talked about it together and just came up with this to be really visually exciting in the bookstore and a great project, great community project. And it just all came together really nicely.
I think serendipitously, you know, at the same time, both of us sort of said, let's do the books, let's do the window. And it just came together really, really nicely. And so we've been folding ever since. But paper
we've had some workshops.
We've had two workshops.
Workshop.
Yes,
yep.
We've done a workshop at Words. We have one coming up on May 18th for special needs children that we're very excited about. It's a wonderful project for manual dexterity and folding, creative thinking, learning a new art form. And I think it's a great project for teens. It sort of fills that gap of what to do with, I think, young adults now. I think it's a cool, lovely, wonderful piece of work that can expand from here. You know, what is next for here? You can come inside, or you can cut, you can shred, you can decorate the binding, you can write letters and poems, and so I think it has a lot of movement to
wow.
go beyond.
Yeah, I wonder if I
so,
can hold this up.
So some of the things in here have been, these are little doodles and poems and stories written by students.
If you turn the book around, someone painted on
and she painted on
the
outside.
Case.
And there's some, as I said, a little
Amazing.
Bit of collaging on the inside of the book. So lots of personal room for decorating. And so it's been a great project. It's been a wonderful surprise for us, really. It's been exciting for me. And as I said, the students have really gone beyond and done really, really cool stuff. And some you can even leave as a flat piece, and you can have this conversation piece on the table, or it can be upright.
Wow.
But this is a series of different folds, and it gets pretty tight, but it's quite lovely. And some are just haphazard. You know, some of these are well planned by students, and some the students just went at it and just started folding at one side, and yet it still works, and it's fresh and different, and so we're quite excited about it.
And the colors are really beautiful.
And the colors are surprising. They kind of pop out, and that's kind of nice. And this is done with a watercolor technique where it's splattered and just washed, and so that's rather fun as well. So, you know, it's been great.
That's terrific. And you don't get so many public works of art, and so it's great to have that.
And we've been happy with Jonah, and you've been so gracious. But just to share your space with us and to put it up, it's been a nice partnership.
But it's such a treat for the community to have that opportunity. It's really a public sculpture.
It is a public, yeah, so thank you.
Now, how many students have worked on this so far?
I would say probably about 175 students.
Wow.
So I have more books. Would you like more books? I have them.
Sure. Maybe our audience, we can...
I might fold one right now, right in the middle.
That would be great. Maybe, you know, maybe we come
back.
We
have many
break,
students
we'll
that have
do
done
that.
This, and we've showed them in our library, and you just have to be careful. You don't want students folding books that are not meant to be folded. So these are sacred paper books. They have been read, and they are being recycled into works of art, but that's it. So,
cool.
But yeah, there have been quite a number of students that have done it.
Great. Well, we're going to be taking a break in a minute, and then when we come back, I want to find out whether you have any other projects in mind or any thoughts for people who are interested in doing that, and then maybe we'll find out a little bit more about what you both do when you're not doing this kind
folding.
Of project.
Okay, great.
So.
After 17 years working as a mason, Mike was laid off. I met him when he came into the library looking for help. He found a job opening, but the application was only online. Mike said he'd spent his entire life around tools, but had never used a computer. I showed him how, and he ended up applying for numerous jobs online. I saw Mike the other day. His new computer skills paid off. He's working again.
New Jersey libraries are transforming lives. Tell us your story.
And we're back in Books in Action. Thank you again. We're here with our special guests, Deborah Kaplan and Claudia Soar. And we're talking about this beautiful Books as Object Art Object project that they have come up with and have displayed around town. We've talked a little bit about the large number of young people who've been involved. Maybe you can tell me, I think you've done some work with special needs kids in this, and perhaps adults, and that's
yes,
maybe
I have,
talk about that.
Very different learners at the school. We have some children with Asperger's and ADHD, and this has been a very successful project for everyone. And some of those students have taught other students how to do it. So it's comforting. It's calming. You can make a very cool, interesting product out of just folding a very simple fold, and some get a little more complicated, but it's been a successful art project for all of my students, and that makes me feel good, and that makes them feel good.
And so, you think adults would enjoy doing this?
Yes.
Definitely.
Very much.
I've been doing it.
Deborah's been folding away, and I've had a number of friends come and stop me and say, could you do a workshop for us? We'd be happy to partake in this.
And would you guys be willing to do other workshops or exhibits elsewhere if there are people who are interested?
Sure. No, that would be great. It would be great if other independent bookstores or libraries wanted to take that into their community and spread it around. I know a librarian came to us on the street and was very interested and she was excited. She wanted to learn how to do it and pass it on to her school. So it would be great
if that
happened.
Fantastic.
Yeah, really great. And she was talking about all the books that were getting thrown out, how it was so upsetting to her. And this was like, she just totally honed in on this as something to do with them, something great. And that would be wonderful. I mean, some people have asked to buy these books, which are not for sale.
Yeah.
It's not, you know, these are individual projects, but...
But you could certainly do it on your own.
Yeah,
it's not
you
that
could just make your own.
The Year of the Kindle, these are to honor, right? So these are our honorable novels, our paper, the obsolete book. Well, hopefully not. But they're just cool little mini works of art, and we're quite happy with them, and it's been fun.
Yeah, it's just amazing that you've devoted your time and have been willing to pitch in and do this for the, again, you're really artists who've together with the young folks who presented a public work of art for the community that's just so spectacular, and it would be wonderful if other places had the opportunity to see it. I think it fits in very well with our community, though, both in terms of that we live in such a talented artistic community and also the green aspect of the community.
Yeah,
sure,
I agree. Yeah.
Now, Deborah, I thought maybe you could tell us a little bit about what you do when you're not creating. Books as art objects.
What I'm not creating books as art objects. Well, I am working at Penguin, so I'm working with books, and I have a love for books, so I am around books a lot. When I have a family, I have a lot of pets, and I have a lot of friends, so I am about Maplewood. I like to do things there. I do things in the city, and I'm busy.
That's great. You say you both lived in Maplewood?
We both have lived in Maplewood for 20 years.
20 years. Yeah. Me too.
And we garden together.
Oh, yeah. We're in a community garden.
Yep.
Nice.
Garden. Yep.
What else?
Bike ride together. We bike ride together. We eat together. We like to do that.
That sounds...
I think, have a love for, I think, for life and for you know, our families and art and exploring just different media and how we can play with that and just bringing it into the community. So it's been really fun to work together. It's been years, Deb. It's been great. It really has been.
That's great.
But Deb and I were both in the commercial art field, and I was in textiles for many years. And then went into teaching. So it's been a very nice shift for me.
How long have you been teaching?
I've been teaching for 13 years.
Wow.
At the middle school.
Great.
And it's proven to be a very good life-changing experience for me. It's been a good, easy, I don't want to say easy. It's been a challenging yet fulfilling career.
Transition.
And a very nice transition and path from textiles. So I brought some of those experiences into the teaching world, and it's been great.
Right.
So, yeah.
And Deborah, tell us what you do at Penguin.
I am the creative director for Young Readers Fiction. So I run a department where we're doing all the book packaging. So I'm used to working with, we're doing the covers, we're doing the jackets, and we work with all illustrators and designers and photographers.
Wow.
So that's book as an object in a different way.
Absolutely. And what do you select the illustrators, or is there someone else who selects them, or do you work with them, or do you have input into the creative ideas for the book covers?
We're the creative department that works with that. We work, obviously, as a team with an editorial group and marketing and sales. And
great.
Yeah.
And how long have you been doing that for?
Quite some time.
That's fine.
Yeah.
That's okay. Well, but for
yes,
many years.
For many years, I've been there and watched publishing change and grow over the years.
That's fantastic.
And I have a real appreciation for independent bookstores because I've obviously watched the big stores, big, you know, get bigger and bigger, and the independent stores get less and less. So I have great appreciation for the ones that are
and
still
in Maplewood,
here.
We have tons of independent stores of all stripes. That's one of the
And I think we
all
like to support that. It is charming, and you have this. You've got a lot of fans, Jonah.
Oh, thank you.
You really do.
You're turning the cameras on me.
But
thank you very much. It's kind of you to say. I know in South Orange there's been some talk about possibly doing, you may not even have heard it yet, but
no,
about possibly doing an exhibit, but I know it would be like to bring, be great to bring your guys' work to South Orange. I think it's...
Oh, that's cool. I think at the Baird Center in South Orange, just around the time we did the window, there was
a book arts
exhibition with different artists who had different things that they were doing. I don't know if anybody was doing folded books, but there were all kinds of things there.
Yeah, there's a big book.
And they would probably be very happy to be in your window.
Mm-hmm. would be nice to have just a collective of different book artists doing different things with books. So, you know, adults or children.
You view this as kind of a form of sculpture. Is that your primary interest in the arts, Claudia, or do you have?
I do enjoy sculpture. I am a painter. I like to paint very much. But in the middle school, we do dabble in some clay. We work on a cycle rotation, so the students just get a chance to get their feet wet in with clay and painting and drawing and paper sculpture. So working with 3D things I like. I think children also like to create things that are 3D. They have a height and a width and a depth to them, and that makes it a little more real for them. And actually folding, you know, taking something that was functional and then making art out of it is kind of a very cool thing for them. You know, so we were starting with this object and then creating something entirely different, but then using the pages as the element to fold or cut or curl or shred and that's been great. So
that's just
thank you for
incredibly creative.
Thanks for your interest.
Incredibly creative, I'll tell you, as I look at each one of these. And are there any guides to the sizes or types of books, or you use both hardcovers and paperbacks?
Good question. That's a good question. Actually, it's most of these that you see here are regular black and white books, fiction. Mm-hmm. But some of the kids did picture books
bound.
Too,
yeah.
And so they were colorful and they were different. The picture books don't have as many pages, so you don't get as much volume. Although you had students that put them together and made.
Some of the students, these are all hardbound books. Oh, this one is a softbound. But with the softbound, I had students folding books from a series. So they would fold the same fold. And then we took off the covers from the softbound, and then we hot glued these books together. So they were creating cylinders. Or some sort of a hanging element, and then you can hang these beautiful mobiles. So that took it into a different direction. And that was interesting. I'd like to work on that a little bit more. So that was kind of cool.
Have you gotten any feedback from the kids' parents at all?
Yeah, very positive and excited, and they want to come, and yeah, it's been all good. It's all good
stuff. And also, I think for the kids to be in front and center in a window, in a place that people see it and walk by it and notice it, was like really exciting for them as well.
That's great.
Yes.
So it's like their first show.
Their work, right. Their work.
That's fantastic. I mean, one of the things that I found gratifying when I saw your workshop was the idea that you had kids teaching other kids how to do it, which I think is also really important. Give kids that kind of teaching opportunity. They seem to enjoy that.
Yeah. Well, we look forward to more workshops and recycling books.
That's terrific. Well, we're going to be wrapping up in a couple of minutes. I don't know if you have anything else you'd like to add about your project. Feel free.
I think we kind of...
You've covered it? Well, that's
great.
I think
we covered it. Yeah.
We covered it.
Well, terrific.
Thank you.
Well,
just to say it was a lot of fun. Right?
It was
I'm
fun.
Glad you both enjoyed
it. Was,
we have
it
to
was
bring
fun.
The fun part
and
in.
It's fairly simple. You can grab a book and you can make this interesting sculpture within a class period. I mean, it just takes time. You just need to slow down and take time. But it's been a lot of fun without a lot of other materials. And that's been the beauty of it, really.
And it's not expensive,
and it's portable,
obviously.
And it's not expensive. These are all found objects, really. That's the great
stuff. That's terrific.
About.
Well, Claudine,
so
Debbie, thank you very much for joining us at Books in Action. And thank you so much. And we look forward to seeing you again at another one of our shows. Thanks for watching.